good morning, dear all my children. See, in our last classes of history, we discussed about Germany unification. This Germany unification we discussed in chapter number 1, Nationalism in Europe. In Germany unification, we have seen that how Germany got unified from multinational dynasty to nation state. What is multinational dynasty? What is nation state? We all have discussed in our all previous videos. Now, in today's course of discussion, we have to talk about Italy unification. But students, before coming to Italy unification, let me tell you one thing. Like Germany, Italy was also divided into nation state, multinational dynasty. Italy was also being divided into multinational dynasty. There was no symbol of nation state in Italy. Then we will see how the transformation took place, how Italy got unified from multinational dynasty to nation state. In today's class, we have to discuss this only. Now see, before coming, let's have a look about the background of Italy. You could see that northern part of Italy, southern part of Italy, eastern part of Italy and western part of Italy. In northern part of Italy, you could see Lombardy and Venetia. In northern part of Italy, you could see Lombardy and Venetia that was under the control of Austrian Empire. Austrian Habsburg Empire. In short, Lombardy and Venetia was under the control of Austrian Habsburg Empire, Austria. The southern part of Italy, was under the control of Bourbon kings of Spain. North part, Lombardy, Venetia was controlled by Austria. The southern part is Kingdom of Two Sicilies. It was under the control of Bourbon king of Spain. Now, when you see the central part of Italy, it was being controlled by Pope. The central part of Italy was under the control of Pope. Only one region, that was Sardinia Piedmont, was under the control of Italian ruler only. Only the one region, that is Sardinia Piedmont, was under the control of Italian king. He was Victor Emmanuel II. Student, it is very important throughout. Name the region that was under the control of Italian king only. So it was Sardinia Piedmont. It was being controlled by Italian king. What was the name of the Italian king? He was Victor Emmanuel II. Now again, it is very, you have to understand the trick. Northern was under the control of North part, L-A-V. In this way you remember, L-A-V. Lombardy and Venetia was under the rule of, under the control of Austria. Here you see South, S for South, S for Sicily and S for Spain. Here you could remember the southern part of Italy, that is Kingdom of Two Sicilies, was under the control of Spain. This is the way you could remember. Sardinia Piedmont was under the control of Italian king only, that was Victor Emmanuel II, and the central was being ruled by Pope. Now student, one thing you need to understand, as we have seen in Germany unification, we talked about heroes. Many heroes, many historic figures we discussed. There we have seen about the role of Prussia. Then we have seen about the Iron Man, that is Otto von Bismarck. So in Italy unification also, we will see, we will look about few personalities, few historical personalities who played an important role to unify Italy. And first of all, we can understand the most important role played by Italian King Victor Emmanuel II. Now why Victor Emmanuel II played an important role? Before that, try to understand about Giuseppe Mazzini. Student, see, we have talked about Giuseppe Mazzini in our previous classes, in our previous videos. There we have talked about Giuseppe Mazzini, how he formed two secret society. He was a young revolutionary from Italy. How he worked so hard in order to unify Italy, but unfortunately he was sent to exile. उसको देश से निकाल दिया गया था. Now you imagine when he was sent to exile, the responsibility of making the Italy fall into the shoulder of Victor Emmanuel II. Now why only Victor Emmanuel II I am talking about? Just because only Sardinia Piedmont, the single area, the single region, it was only under the control of Italian king. Apart, it was all somehow been controlled by another ruler. Italy was being divided into seven multinational dynasties. Only out of that seven, Sardinia Piedmont was under the control of Italy king only. That is why when Giuseppe Mazzini was sent to exile, the responsibility of making Italy unified fall into the shoulder of Victor. Now student, you see the role of different people towards Italy unification. As we have seen the role of Count Otto von Bismarck in Germany unification, we have to pay our attention towards the role of different personalities in making Italy unified. First of all, Victor Emmanuel II, he was the king of Italy, Sardinia Piedmont that time. Giuseppe Mazzini, he was the young revolutionary who set two secret society in order to counter the effect of conservatives. What is conservative? We have discussed earlier only. Conservatism, how it has come in Europe after the defeat of Napoleon Bonaparte in the year 1815. Then we have to see about Count Cavour. We have to talk about Count Cavour, what was his role, who was he, and then finally we have to talk about Giuseppe Garibaldi. Again, I am telling you students, we in Italy unification, we have to talk about Victor Emmanuel II, Giuseppe Mazzini, Count Cavour and Giuseppe Garibaldi. Now you pay attention, first of all, after Giuseppe Mazzini being sent to exile, the entire responsibility of making Italy unified fall into the shoulder of Italy king of Sardinia Piedmont. He was Victor Emmanuel II. Victor Emmanuel II with the help of Count Cavour. Now who was Count Cavour? He was the chief minister of Italy that time. Count Cavour was the chief minister of Italy. He was neither a democratic nor a revolutionary. Important here student, pay attention. Count Cavour was not a revolutionary, he was neither a democrat, but also he helped to make Italy unified. He was an elite class person. He was an upper class. He belongs to an upper class, but also he worked for the unification of Italy. Like other elite section of society in Europe, he too, Count Cavour too, speaks French in order to show his eliteness. जैसे और जो लोग थे, और जो एलीट लोग थे यूरोप में, वो फ्रेंच बोलते थे अपने डोमिनेंस को, अपने एलीटनेस को शो करने के लिए. जस्ट वैसे ही काउंट कैवर यूज टू स्पीक इटली, काउंट कैवर यूज टू स्पीक फ्रेंच टू शो हिज डोमिनेंस पार्ट. Now Victor Emmanuel II, with the help of Count Cavour, let Austria flee from Lombardy and Venetia. Victor Emmanuel II के help से, Count Cavour और Victor Emmanuel के together policy से Austria हार गया. Lombardy and Venetia northern part से Austria को जाना पड़ा. अब with the help of this Giuseppe Garibaldi, this Giuseppe Garibaldi helped Spain to move from Kingdom of Two Sicilies. Kingdom of Two Sicilies जो southern part था, वहाँ से स्पेन को हटाने में किसने मदद किया? Giuseppe Garibaldi. Now Giuseppe Mazzini, we cannot forget about him because he was the only one who at very young age started working for the unification of Italy and to counter the upliftment of the conservatism. There we have seen in today's class about Italy unification. First we have to talk about Italy's background. It was being divided into seven kingdoms. North was under the control of Lombardy and Venetia. The northern part of Italy was under the control of Austrian, Habsburg Austrian king. The southern part of Italy, that is the Kingdom of Two Sicilies, it was under the control of Spain. Now you see, the central was under the control of Pope, and only one part, that is Sardinia Piedmont, it was under the control of Victor Emmanuel II. Who was he? He was the king of Sardinia Piedmont that time. Which played an important role in making Italy unifying? Count Cavour, Victor Emmanuel II, Giuseppe Garibaldi and Giuseppe Mazzini. In this way, Italy transformed from a multinational dynasty to a nation state. That's all for today. Thank you.